Hare Krishna. Was Karna the second best archer after Arjuna? Not necessarily, because he was defeated by at least two other archers. On the 13th day of the Kurukshetra war, when the Chakravyuha had been set up, so Abhimanyu penetrated the Chakravyuha and was devastating the Kaurava army from within. At that time, the Kauravas were at their wits' end. None of them was able to check Arjuna. At that time, Duryodhana told Karna that, you know, you had said that you will kill Partha, but you are not able to deal with his son also. Karna had attempted his best, and he had been wounded severely and had fallen back. And Karna, hearing these words, was goaded, and he once again attacked Abhimanyu. And once again, he was repulsed, and he was just overpowered by the ferocity of Abhimanyu's attack. And at that time, in despair, Karna said that, you know, we have to ask Drona, he's our commander. He has to come up with some means by which he can be defeated. And then they came up with the vicious plan of six warriors attacking him alone. So the point was, Karna could not match Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu defeated him on the 13th day. And again, another formidable warrior on the side of the Pandavas who bested Karna was Bhima. First of all, Bhima and Karna confronted each other long before the Kurukshetra war, when Yudhishthir was going to perform the Rajasuya Yajna. At that time, Bhima had been sent to conquer in the eastern direction. And Bhima confronted Karna at that time, and the result was there was a big war, intense war, but Bhima defeated Karna, and then Karna agreed to come to the Kuru assembly, to the Pandavas' Rajasuya sacrifice, and offered tribute over there. This is the first occasion when Bhima defeated Karna. Then again on the 14th day also, when Arjuna had decided to take a vow, had taken a vow to kill Jayadrath before sunset, and Arjuna had penetrated deep into the Kaurava forces. At that time, Karna came to check Arjuna, and Bhima had been sent by Yudhishthir to assist Arjuna, and Bhima challenged Karna at that time. And Bhima and Karna had a fierce fight, but Bhima held Karna back. So Karna was not able to swerve Arjuna from advancing towards Jayadrath. So Bhima more than equaled Karna over here. Then later on, this was the 14th day. And on 16th day, when Karna had been made the commander of the Kaurava army, and then when he was the commander at that time, in the 16th and the 17th days, so especially he was the commander, but on 16th day, when Karna was fighting and Bhima was fighting against him, and they kept fighting, and then Bhima just knocked Karna back with the ferocity of the arrows, and then he attacked Dushyasan. And so fierce was his attack that Dushyasan was overpowered, and Karna observed Bhima killing Dushyasan, and Karna was just so petrified he couldn't do anything. Right in front of Karna's eyes, Bhima killed not just Dushyasan but several other of the Kaurava brothers. And Bhima killed even Karna's brother and Karna's son. And yet, Karna was overpowered. Karna could not do anything. So here again, Bhima proved himself to be far more forceful and superior to Karna. And then, of course, there is one incident when Karna did get the better of Bhima. They, in a bow and arrow fight, they fought fiercely, and eventually Karna knocked off, broke Bhima's chariot, and Bhima was immobilized and Bhima was on the ground. And at that time, Karna with his arrows had the opportunity to kill Bhima, but he did not kill Bhima because he had given a vow to Kunti that he would not kill any of her sons except Arjuna. And he came right up to Bhima and knocked him on the head with his bow, and he said, "Oh, you child, you should not fight with your superiors. You are just a fat buffoon. You are a glutton. You know, go to the kitchen and eat over there." He viciously insulted a formidable and respectable warrior like Bhima. At that time, Bhima was seething with anger and he challenged Karna. He says, come off the chariot and fight and wrestle with me, and today I'll crush your pride and crush you. But Karna refused to accept that challenge. And Bhima had the power to pound Karna to death with his own fists. But Bhima held back because he remembered the vow that Arjuna had taken, that Arjuna was going to kill Karna. And that's why Bhima did not do anything, and Bhima just departed from that place. So this incident is often seen as Karna sparing Bhima because of his vow to Kunti. But it can be seen the other way also, because in close quarters, in fist fight or in muscular fight, Karna was no match to Bhima. So this incident can also be seen as Bhima sparing the life of Karna because in order to honor Arjuna's vow. Either way, what we can see is that Bhima did prove himself on some occasions to be superior to Karna. So Karna was definitely a great archer, but he was one among many. He was not the one above many. The one above many was Arjuna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.